Tonande bak, tonande bek, te duse gite ya moa, tenande tak, tenande tek, herumenta la sedulu. Hail Sabriman trapped in the dark, hail Sabriman adrift on thy bark, dark lords banish, thy reign is nigh, my time to bring the orb. My undead lords within the core, your name I hail, enfold the orb!
What the heck?
Donande tak, donande tek, heru menta la sed. Damn.
Hun? You want bacon?
You know I do! Damn TV!
Lousy second-rate candle makers, kill them all when I rule the world. What sort of half-baked operation do they think I'm running here? Now where was I? I call upon the power of one dark name, one black heart, one grievous soul. I call upon the power of Remora Santissima!
What the?
At last, the power of the orb is mine, and with it the souls of the dead. Soon I shall rule triumphant over all of Nox!
Blazes! What manner of demon spawn dares attack my ship? Off, you mutant imp, or you'll have no head to put a hat on!
Wait, please! I need your help! I don't know what's happened, or where I am, or... What is this place?
No place at all, except the clouds. But off the noble Julian you go, under your power, or by the lift of my boot!
Ah!
Hold on, what's this?
It's my TV.
And what does this TV do?
Do? It doesn't really do anything. You just watch it.
See, here's where you plug it in, and this knob changes the channels. I think it's broken.
Intoxicating. The look of it promises a host of mysteries.
You should see it when it's on.
Give me the glass box, imp, and I'll spare you your deadly plummeting fate.
Why do you keep calling me imp? My name is Jack.
Granted, you've no wings, but you fly like an imp.
I can't fly. I fell. I fell here from my living room.
Fell from what? No matter. It's either overboard with gravity as your guide, or I take the TV as fare for safe passage. Deal?
Can you take me home? Tina made bacon tonight.
Bacon bound we go, imp. But first, I need your help with something.
Howdy, folks, and welcome to Let's Play Nox. This was released by Westwood Entertainment in 2000. You would know Westwood from some other games I've played, notably Lands of Lore. This is a... I would consider it an action RPG. It's a game that I don't think is too well known, but it's something I remember playing growing up, and I think it's a pretty decent game. So we're gonna play solo here, because the single player quest is the single player quest. And I've had this for a while, as you can see. I've been meaning to start playing it, but I haven't. Alright, that's the autosave, so we're just going to start a new character here. And you have three different classes you can pick from here in the beginning. Each has its own focus, and each has its own storyline. Normally, I play the warrior or the conjurer, because those are my two favorite classes, but I think I'm going to play the wizard, because they get really ridiculous later in the game, and I like throwing fireballs. So, we're going to hit accept. And you can kind of customize yourself here. We're just going to stay as Jack, why not? We'll give him a beard, and some sideburns, and a mustache. Can we make them? Oh yeah. Now. We're gonna make him a redhead here. Well, orange. Mac and cheese head, maybe? I don't know, what's this look like? That's a bit more reasonable. The color of your starting clothes really doesn't matter because you switch them out. So we're just gonna give him some nice puke green colored clothes here. Because why not? And And we're gonna have a penchant for some fiery death. Fiery death. Anyways, now that I'm done with that, here we go.
The work of a great wizard is a sight to behold, a mastery of magical power channeled to the most astounding effect. So, you should know that in all of Nox, Horvath is the name synonymous with the greatest of wizards. And your timing is auspicious. As I speak, Horvath is looking for an apprentice. Win his favor, and his sacred citadel will become your home, the Wizard's Tower in Castle Galliver. Succeed with him, and your future on Nox is assured. Hard cold facts, lad. You must become a wizard's apprentice before you can gain entry to the Tower of Illusion. The one controlling that is the Archwizard Horvath, an old friend of mine. I know Horvath is in need of a worthy apprentice, but are you worthy, lad? Follow the beach road, find the home of his new apprentice, and beware of urchins. They can be the most nettlesome of pests at best. I guarantee you don't want to learn their worst, lad.
Okay, then. Alright, the controls in this are pretty basic. You click to attack, and as you can see, there's a little cooldown on whatever weapon, so you can't, like, spam too hardcore. Right mouse button moves, and that is the vast majority of the game. You've got hotkeys down here. We don't have any spells yet. Wizards and conjurers get spells. Warriors get, like, combat techniques that they can provide. And as you can see, there are secrets. Many, many secrets in this game. And we get goodies for finding them, so let's... The sign reads, open chests for fabulous prizes. And this one reads, break barrels to obtain the goodies inside. So you smash it a barrel, and we got some gold. And in this we have some more gold. Well, heck yeah. Alright, anyways, we flee into the distance. Let's see what we can find. Oh, we have our first spell here. Collect spell books to gain new spells. It's probably like magic missile. Yup, missiles of magic. And one thing that I always remembered from this game was the spell casting, because your character actually says little magic words.
John.
And I always thought that was really cool. And these are our potions. We've got mana and healing potions. There are other ones you can find, like cure poison and stuff, but we hopefully won't be needing those for a while. And that is an urchin right there. Now, the combat in this game is real time, so if you're, you know, skilled, you can move out of the way of attacks. One thing I remember most about this was the first game I ever really played heavily multiplayer. My little brother and I played this game obsessively multiplayer, both PvP and the released, they released a game mode that was more or less like Gauntlet, and they called it Nox Quest, and that was very fun too, and I could not tell you how many countless hours I have whiled away playing those various game modes, and that was back in the day of, you know, dial-up internet connections, so... You know, the lag was horrendous and all that good jazz. Some more gold here. And this is a game that it pays to explore in. And I believe, yes, spacebar jumps. There are some jumping puzzles, but they're typically not too bad. Let's see what we got here. 75 experience points. And a spider! Did I just magic missile? And that one too. And that one. And we got some boots. Alright. Now, since we had crappy shoes equipped, it automatically equipped this. It will do that for everything except, I believe, weapons. It never replaces your weapons. You do have two weapon slots. If you hit V, it swaps between them. For wizards, we're typically, as a wizard, we're going to be using our staff, and we will find magic staffs that let us cast spells, and that's going to be about it. See, if you hit Tab, it brings up your minimap, so you can kind of see where you're going. Which is handy later in the game because it gets pretty confusing. Oh, hi guys.
Thieving little creatures. The urchins just moved into our area and have already made absolute pests of themselves. I am Archwizard Horvath. I am looking for my apprentice. I fear he has been lost in a nearby urchin den. If you could find him and bring him back to me, I would be willing to bring you along with us to Galliver. Come, I will show you the way to the wretched urchin den outside my apprentice's home.
Okay. And this is a game that I'm actually kind of sad that more wasn't done with it, because I really like this game engine. Alright, here's the exit to the home, but we're gonna poke around. But I really like this game engine. A lot of really cool things could have been done with it, and it's a shame that nothing really came of it, like no sequels or anything. I probably have to talk to him, don't I?
Here's a spellbook and some other articles you might need. To unlock the gates, just follow the road, and I expect you will have no trouble finding these detestable interloping urchins. Good luck.
Now, what else? One other thing. We have a beast scroll table of contents. As a wizard, that will just give us little tidbits of information about monsters. However, if you're a conjurer, you can use beast scrolls to summon monsters. Come here, you little bastard. That's right. Got a stick. I'm beating them with it. And some more gold. But yeah, this is more or less the game in a nutshell. You kind of just adventure and listen to good music and kill things and die a lot. And there is a plot line. We haven't bumped into it yet. You saw some of it in the intro movie, which I actually haven't recorded yet. I'm recording it after I record this. But you saw the main antagonist, I should say, in the villain, the woman, and our main character, Jack. So, and his amazing TV. Oh hey, it's an apprentice. And we need a sapphire key to unlock the gate. Okay. I'm a ninja! Can't hit me! My magic missiles don't miss, though. Little crap. I don't know what it was trying to do, but it failed and I beat it to death. What do we got here? Some apples, which are healing items. Later in the game, I believe we will find food items that we can carry with us, and they more or less function as cheap healing items, like in lieu of potions. Now, one cool thing about this game, I don't know if they're going to hit us with any of it right now, but they have some intriguing puzzles. Oh, what do we got here? A beast scroll, see? Cowardly rock-lobbing denizens of the world beneath. Urchins are best experienced face-to-face. And if we were a conjurer, there would be a little symbol above the name over here on the left, and we could drag it down into our spell bar to summon them. But I want to look around before I go breaking those barrels of water. You see an urchin painting titled Pretty Colors. Come here. Sticked! Okay, anything in here? What's out of this chest? Just some gold, okay. Because those water barrels, we can use those to extinguish fire. So if there's like this huge fire pit or something out here, like this, they're just providing some. You can push them forward, and they put it out. And there you go. Walking through lava hurts. A lot. Try jumping instead. Yeah, we could walk through this lava and it probably wouldn't kill us, but I'd rather not wait. Risk it. Because, bad things happen to silly adventurers who think that walking in lava is a good idea. And as you can see, we don't have many hit points. So I just drink a mana potion on accident. Check our stats here. Yeah, we've got, 75 health. So, no, we have 20 health. I'm sorry. 75 is the most we will ever have, I believe. That's not including items. I'm fairly certain that you can find items that increase your stats by little bits. Another secret here. But yes, wizards are squishy, however, their destructive power is immense. Hey, you little bastards. I don't know what this does. Oh, it opened a spider! Oh my god. I killed it. Yeah, I don't like spiders. Oh, there's a potion of cure poison. Because I'm assuming then that was a poisonous spider. There we go. Now, when we picked up that mana potion, it automatically drank it because we weren't at full mana. That's something that is somewhat obnoxious. I'm not sure if you can disable it or not. but it's not too bad. There are a lot of potions in this game. I'm not really particularly worried about it. Typically, you end up with an overabundance of them, because you can only carry 9 of each type. Alright.
Thank you for trying to rescue me, but I'm already too far gone. The urchins, they weren't acting alone. It was a necromancer.
Oh, darn. Hey, look, a robe. And a spell. Ooh, lightning. I'm a real wizard now. I got the robe. All I need is the funny hat. And I have lightning, which, if I recall correctly, is an auto target. You don't have to point at anything, it just fries. Well, Horvath, I've got some bad news for you. You might notice by the fact that I'm wearing your apprentice's robe. He's dead.
My apprentice's robe. Dark fortunes must have befallen him. You have proven the urchins were no match for you. Perhaps you might make a good apprentice. Yes. Follow me to the laboratory. When you are ready, just step into the teleporter, and you will be brought to Galliver. We have much work ahead of us when we arrive.
Oh, yes, we do. He sure gets over loss quick. Alright, and these blue things, you might have noticed it when I was in the cave. I walked up to some blue crystals. These restore your mana when you're near them. See? As I cast spells, it recharges, but it dims. They only have so much to them. So what do you got to say?
When you are ready, just step onto the teleporter.
Teleporter!
I could not have anticipated this development, lad, as events seem to be moving at their own unsettling speed. You have been called upon by Horvath to go to the mysterious Wizard Tower. He must believe in you, because he is entrusting you to apprentice with him and to do research in the Forgotten Library.
Oh, damn.
Welcome to the city of Galliver, realm of the wizards. You will be my new apprentice. Everything has been arranged. You may shop for anything you need, but do not tarry too long. I shall meet you in my office inside the Tower of Illusion. Just take Spire Street and you will find the tower.
Okay, then. And I'm actually going to turn music down just a little bit. There. Alright, welcome to town. This game is somewhat episodic in nature in that once you finish in one area, you typically... You don't have free reign of, like, going back to areas. It's kind of linear, is the word that I should have used. We will find, like, merchants and stuff. Typically, every chapter, like, is a different quest. Oh, hey, dude.
The captain is a great man. You would be wise to listen to his advice.
Okay. But anyways, typically every chapter that you explore is a different area. And each area has merchants and stuff in it, so you don't have to worry about only being able to shop in town and stuff.
Wanna buy an apple? They're smuggled in from the vast orchards of Dunmir.
No, that's okay. A mighty staff. I think that's a staff that increases our strength, which I don't really care too much about. I'm gonna sell some stuff, though. Well, I guess I'm just gonna sell my... I'm gonna sell my pants and shirt. I'm gonna sell my pants and shirt. Jack's a naughty boy. He's going commando under his robe. Let's poke around and see if we can't find anybody that'll sell us anything interesting. Who are you?
Hello, young mage. I surmise you might be here about the reward. There's a handsome bounty for Morgan Lightfingers, dead or alive. He and his sorry band of thieves have been preying on our fair town for weeks. Be careful. You don't want to be caught off guard by those savage scum.
Okay, now there are side quests in this. And that is one right there. We are going to actually pursue it. I think I remember where this guy actually is. Yeah, he's down in the sewers, of course. Where all thieves are. Oh, hey, dude, bro. Oh, my God.
Your failure to retrieve the all-important book and amulet from the Wizard Tower is pathetic. Because of your failure, all Nox will lay in ruin, just as I planned.
It looks like we got caught off guard. Ow. And thankfully the game auto-saves. Because otherwise I'd be somewhat upset right now. But instead I'm not.
Wizards are always welcome here. What can I interest you in?
You can buy my clothes. And then you can show me what you've got for sale. Ooh, a cloak. I want a cloak. Everybody wants a cloak. I could buy some actual, you know, normal pants. But you know what? No. Jack is very attached to his commandoing. It makes him feel, I don't know, daring.
Welcome to the Griffin's Nest. My inn may not be as fancy as Maximilian's, but I guarantee you a peaceful rest.
I don't really want to sleep. I want to loot, so I'm going to do that. I don't believe you can get in trouble for looting in this game. I don't think. I'm not 100% on that though, so I'm gonna try and keep it on the down low. I'm however gonna smash the crap out of everything. Maybe. I am but a weak wizard boy. I'm a weak wizard family. I don't know. I'm just gonna stop. Potion cure poison? Okay. I'm gonna leave the rest of those things. That is a nice blue cloak you have there.
I've heard strange and disturbing stories about the land of the dead. Something about walking skeletons. I don't know who spreads these insane rumors.
Yeah, totally insane. I am, however, going to save. Now, sadly, you can't label your saves in this game, which means I'm at some point most likely going to get confused and rage about it. But that's okay. We just have to accept that it's going to happen.
Are you? Welcome to the Church of St. Alistair. You may consider the church grounds safe haven for rest and meditation.
Okie dokie. Anything worth anything? Nope. Alright. Just gonna meander on around here. Got a graveyard up there. Let's see, what do we got here? Sign reads Kincaid's Armor.
Kincaid's Armor, at your service. What can I do for you, Sir Wizard?
I don't know. How much will you give me for this? 47. That would put me at 400 exactly. I would be 7 short. Let's see here. There. Drake running around in his tighty whities. There. We now have better armor. What we got here? The Wizard's Keep. Well, hello there, red-eyed
Welcome
dude.
Welcome to the Wizard's Keep. How can I help you?
Book of Lesser Heal and some Beast Scrolls. Really not too interested on account of I already have Lesser Heal. What is this? Maximilian's. Alright, that's the expensive inn. Okay, I just have to remember where the wizardy place of wizarding is. So I think it might be through here? Yes. The Tower of Illusion!
So, you're Horvath's new apprentice. Impressive. Master Horvath's chamber is down the hall to your right, first door past the elevator. I've unlocked the south doors for you. Welcome to the guild.
Okay. Down the hall, first door on the right, past the elevator. Okay, well there's the elevator, first door on the right. You're not Master
Welcome
Horvath.
Welcome to the tower gift shop and trinkets. Can I help you?
I'm lost already! Oh, there we are.
You're here. Good. Your first task as my new apprentice is very important. Something strange is transpiring in Nox. Wildlife incursions in the settled areas is on a steady rise. My attempts to scry out the cause have been fruitless. A mysterious force clouds my view. You may help me change that.
Okay.
There is an underground section of the library where our archives are kept. Before this tower was built, it served as our main repository of tomes and related articles. It contains numerous secret bookcases and a few traps, which were originally designed to keep out uninvited visitors.
So does that mean I can keep anything I find?
Most of this forgotten section of the library has not been used in many years. The antiquated records indicate this section contains two items which might be crucial to my investigation. The first is the Amulet of Clarity. The second is the Book of Oblivion. If you can retrieve these objects for me quickly, I hope they will help furnish the answers I seek.
Well, okay, I guess that means I can't loot. Being a jerk and interrupting me and stuff. Poke around and break your alchemy stuff! I'm a spiteful little bastard. I hate you, Horvath, you mean!
Can I help you, son? Horvath asked you to fetch something for him, eh? Sure thing, son. Let me unlock the gates for you. One moment.
Thank you. What we got here? M. Booth Memorial Library. Save because I'm a coward time. Yes. Did you hear that? That evil laughter? Hey, guys.
Hey, you shouldn't be in here. Who are you?
I am the servant of Hecubah, queen of the necromancers. I come for the Book of Oblivion. Surrender it now.
Lads, escort this madman out of here.
Ha ha ha! Pitiful wizards are no match for a necromancer. Oh! Thanks for the book, old man. Tell Horvath that my queen would like to meet him someday. Soon.
Oh, how can this be? That evil one defeated both of my novices. There's no time to summon help. Quickly, you must stop him before the Book of Oblivion is lost.
My voice acting shows just how concerned I am with all of this. We shouldn't tarry around and loot everything while the necromancer escapes. I'm emoting. Ah. Okay, I'm done making fun of the voice acting. For now. Freaking spiders. And we do kind of want to conserve our spell points. I think they regenerate naturally. All the same, I kind of want to take it kind of easy for now. Kinda look at our maps. Alright, as you can see, there are two little pixels that are off here on the map. That means that there's probably a secret door right there. Yep. Yeah, you can kind of use the mini-map to cheat like that. Okay, there we go. I was gonna say, I bet this is a trap. Swap location. Okay. I wonder how I'm supposed to get out of here. I'm so confused. I'm just gonna kill everything. Ah, you little bastard. Alright. Hey, oh my god, that wasn't what I wanted to do, but okay. Alright, now the thing with the lightning spell is, not only do I not have to, target things with it, but it deals damage based on how long you're standing still, so, like, technically, you could kill anything with it if you had enough mana, and it works pretty quickly, but I will be swapping it out. I think I'm gonna specialize more as, like, a fire mage than a generalist or, like, a lightning mage or anything. Although there is one spell later that I'm going to use, and that's the Death Ray. There is a spell literally called Death Ray, and I will be using that one quite extensively because it's an amazing spell. And kind of overpowered because it pretty much kills everything in one hit. But we won't be getting that until near the end of the game, so I'm not too worried. And I think I remember its little magical turn. I think it's like Et Do. And the reason I remember that is because I used to spam the ever-living crap out of it in the multiplayer. And when you cast it, it sounds like a gunshot going off. It's like a pew. It's awesome. Alright. There. Alright, we have sapped all the energy from that. What do we got here? Book of Force Field. Surround yourself with a swirling ball of energy deflecting half of all harm leveled at you. Until the shield collapses, no single blow can kill you. Okay then. You don't have enough mana, alas. How much mana does it cost? 80. I have 78. Okay. Trap, maybe?
These should slow you down.
Oh, he's a conjurer of cheap tricks. Oh god, giant spiders. Why is it always giant spiders? I hate spiders. I hate them! Eek! Especially these black ones, because I know they poison the crap out of you. Oh my god. Chewing on my potions. Freaking bats. Get out of here. Silly little urchins. Oh. Well, hello there. Some more gold. And a potion that I'm really not too interested in, but hey. I will not complain. And this is a game that kind of rewards you for poking around. There are some areas that are actually pretty well hidden in it. And there are a pretty good number of secrets throughout the game. So you've always got a reason to kind of take your time running through areas and stuff. Wow, these are metal framed boxes. We can't break them. What do we got here? Ah, that would be why. Yep, there are block-pushing puzzles. Did I buy... Oh, I didn't buy a shirt and pants. I'm gonna take these, though. Oh god, it's a little death machine! Oh, we just gained a level! You have achieved the next level! Yeah! More or less, it just heals your mana and stuff. Restores your mana and stuff, and ups your stats a little bit. So, yeah. Nothing to complain about. Free heals and all that good jazz. What do we got here? Book of Fireball. Yes, please. Oh, we've got our second spell set now. See, I think... See, shift lets us target... if we hit shift, we can flip the targets on things so that we can, like, target, like, say, an enemy with a heal or an ally with a heal spell. Show all spell sets. So I want to kind of move stuff around here. There. I know there's a hotkey to switch. Next spell set, E&R. Okay. Dang it. E&R. Alright. I'm never going to remember that, but okay. And I got Fireball. And a key, which probably unlocks this. Yep. I got Oh, those are nice and mean looking. Flying Leap! Oh, hey. Fireball. Done. Oh. You guys are going to have to get used to hearing up. Flimsy Wizard Robe of the Wasp's Bane. So we got our first magic item. I want to say that these are, like, poison resistance. Yeah, it has level 1 poison protection on it. Okay. Flip off the identify. And as you can see, it's a different color. And there's, like, all kinds of resistances. There's, you've got, you know, poison, fire, etc., etc. So I'm not supposed to get, like, down this wall. No. Hello, anybody home? I'm here to kind of kill all of you and take your stuff. Oh, hey, giant spider.
Done.
Oh, God. I need to learn how to aim the fireballs. I immediately regret this. Hey, I'm not done yet. Damn it. That one got him. Okay. So we got a path here. Oh, God, and bats, apparently. I'm gonna kind of check and see what's in these other areas. I'm curious. Some mana restoring pylons. We must apparently construct additional pylons. Come on, you folks didn't seriously think I'd say pylon and not make that joke. Seriously. Come on now. Give me some credit. Oh, hi, guys. There's no friendly fire from your spells in this game, thankfully. Oh, we got our wizard's hat. We're officially a mage now. We've got the dorky hat. Hell yeah. Alright, we also have 30 minutes worth of recording time, so I'm going to save it and call it an episode here. So, as per usual, folks, thanks for watching, and I will catch you all next time.